No matter the size of your greenhouse or what products you grow, keeping your workers safe should be your number one priority. Training is an essential tool in maintaining an accident-free workplace. It's very likely that the size of your greenhouse workforce will fluctuate over time, depending on the season and your specific production needs. But the men and women that you employ at the start of the growing season may be different than those at the end of the season. As well, some of your seasonal workers may be from outside Canada, such as Latin America, where Spanish is their first language. All these factors combined can make it challenging for you to deliver consistent and effective safety training to all your employees. One solution to this challenge is to produce short training videos. In a moment, we'll describe how you can create simple but effective videos. But first, let's review why it makes sense for you to produce your own short training videos. As a visual medium, video makes it easier for your workers to understand and remember the information you're delivering. Using video ensures you are always delivering a consistent message to all your workers, particularly if your training staff changes. When new employees start working with you, short training videos can serve as a supplement to your live training, effectively highlighting the key messages you are delivering. The medium of video enables workers to learn at their own pace, watching and re-watching a video as needed until they fully grasp the content. In addition, training videos can be shown over and over again. With a team of employees that's been on the job for some time, replaying a video provides a safety refresher that reinforces proper work practices. Training videos that you produce will be more effective than off-the-shelf videos because their content is customized. You can show your own greenhouse and equipment, demonstrate your own safety procedures, and feature your own workers. And, as we'll see in a moment, short training videos can be both affordable and quick to produce. It's important to remember, however, that training videos do not replace your live hands-on training and the need for ongoing supervision of your workers. Now, how easy is it for you to produce your own short training videos? Actually, it's easier than you might think. The first thing to remember is that you're not trying to make a Hollywood blockbuster. All you really need to do to make an effective training video is to present a clear message in a simple and straightforward manner. The first step in preparing a video is to ask yourself, what exactly should my video focus on? What's the topic? Here are three examples. A. What equipment am I demonstrating how to use? B. What operating procedures am I trying to explain? C. What unsafe behaviors am I trying to highlight? Clearly identifying your topic is crucial in order to keep your video short and to avoid confusing your workers with unrelated information or unnecessary detail. Jeffrey's Greenhouses Incorporated in St. Catharines, Ontario, actively produces its own short training videos and has kindly agreed to let us use several of its videos here as examples. Let's begin with a brief segment from a video that demonstrates how to use a piece of equipment, in this case, an electric cart.
On the dashboard of the electric cart is the steering wheel with the horn in the center. There is a starter key lock which has an off position at the 12 o'clock position and an on position at the 2 o'clock position. The direction selector button, which is to the right of the key, has three possible positions. Press down at the top of the button to move forward, not press down at either end for neutral, and press down at the bottom of the button to move backwards.
You saw how the woman in the video pointed to specific parts of the dashboard, then talked about and actually showed how to use the starter key and the direction selector button. Here's a short clip from a different video, this time explaining one procedure for working safely with the greenhouse's overhead monorail.
At Plant 1, in compartments 5, 11, and 18 only, where the greenhouse roofs are higher, the monorail mover cart is used when the monorail needs to be moved into a different bay. This mover cart is used to help reduce the strain of lowering and lifting the monorail when at a greater distance.
Did you notice how specific the narrator was when she said, at Plant 1, in compartments 5, 11, and 18 only? She also briefly provided the rationale for using the monorail mover cart. By giving the reason why a procedure should be done a particular way, in this case, to reduce the strain, your workers are more likely to remember the procedure and do it correctly on their own. Finally, here's a short clip from a third video that highlights an unsafe work behavior. Take a look.
When storing racks in tight spaces, notice my right hand here as I end up jamming it between two racks. The proper way of moving a rack into a tight space is by moving your fingers on the inside of the shipping rack. And then to complete storing the rack, I block the turning wheels with any type of wood or bricks to prevent the rack from rolling away.
First, you saw the man demonstrate the wrong way to store the rolling rack in tight places, followed by the right way to complete this same task. This wrong way, right way approach helps your workers clearly understand how they could get hurt and how they can avoid an injury. When finalizing your topic, resist the temptation of packing too much content into a single video. Most people have quite short attention spans and tend to tune out after a few minutes. If you need to cover a lot of information, break the topic into two or more separate videos. The second step in preparing your own training video involves developing the specific content of the video. Now that you've nailed down your general topic, it's time to think through the exact points you wish to cover. In effect, you're writing the script for your video. For instance, if you're demonstrating how to use a piece of equipment, make a list of all the parts you wish to point out. If you're explaining an operating procedure, write out all the steps involved in completing the task. If you're highlighting an unsafe work behavior, describe the wrong way to complete the task, then the right way to do it. In developing your content, it's wise to consult your organization's safety policies or standard operating procedures to make sure you've got everything right. You may find it helpful to write out your points on sticky notes and then post them on a wall, which makes it easy to add or rearrange your content as you go. Voila! You've created your video's storyboard. The final step in completing your own training video involves the actual production process. There are several stages involved in producing your video. A. Shooting the video scenes. B. Assembling the video scenes. C. Recording the narration. And D. Editing everything together. And if you wish to produce the video in a second language, there's also the issue of translation. Don't worry. Producing your video is not as complicated as it looks. To shoot your video scenes, you can use your mobile phone or a simple digital camera. You need to decide who will be seen in the video. Will you appear on screen and someone else holds the camera, or the other way around? If you're using a mobile phone, hold it sideways so the frame is in landscape format, like this video. You don't need a tripod. Using your storyboard, divide your script up into short segments or scenes. Then shoot each scene separately, and not necessarily in their final order. Don't try to shoot the whole video in one take. Before you begin shooting, plan the best angle for shooting each scene. Would it be more effective to tell the story through the eyes of the worker, or rather from the viewpoint of a third person watching the work activity? Consider the lighting. Try to avoid shooting into the sun, since the action you're showing may end up being too dark. Shoot a test scene first. As we'll see in a moment, the people in your video don't need to talk on camera. However, it's useful to record the real-life background sound of the action you're shooting. If the scene you're shooting has other workers in the background, it's okay if they smile when you're filming. That just makes the video more real. Don't worry if you don't get everything right the first time. Even the pros need multiple takes. The next step is to assemble the scenes you've shot in the correct sequence. This is the first stage in the video editing process. Video editing software is readily available and is surprisingly easy to use. Apple Macintosh computers come with iMovie built in. For Windows computers, you can purchase Microsoft HD Movie Maker Pro for about $20. Chances are, a young person or someone else you know is already familiar with video editing software. At this stage, you are simply importing the scenes you've shot into the editing software, and then arranging them in the same sequence as your sticky note storyboard. Now it's time to record your video's narration. You can use your mobile phone or a separate audio recording device to capture the narration. Find a quiet space in which to make the recording in order to minimize background noise. Assuming that you wrote the video, it's likely that you will be the person recording the video script. And since viewers won't see you speaking on screen, the narration track is a voiceover. In preparing the voiceover script, it's useful to write out, word for word, exactly what you'll say. In the script, you can either use the first person point of view, like this.
Here in the video, you can see I gently move the rack, and I can tell that the pair closest to me are the ones that are the turning wheels.
Or you can use the third person, like this.
Stand in the neutral position, stand tall, feet hip-width apart, and reach both hands in front of you and interlock your fingers with your palms facing out.
Either way, keep the language simple and easy to understand. Use short words. Avoid using jargon and acronyms. And don't speak too fast. The advantage of having the voiceover recorded after the video scenes have been assembled is that you can space out your sentences and add or subtract words if needed, so that the narration matches up with what appears on the screen. If you need to produce your video in a second language, this is when it happens. Let's assume you need a Spanish version. In an ideal world, you would have someone who speaks Spanish directly record the narration. To prepare a Spanish script, you can simply use Google Translate or a similar online translation tool. But since finding a suitable Spanish narrator may be difficult, a great alternative is to have the English voiceover script digitally recorded in Spanish. There's a free website, Text-to-Speech, that can quickly convert your English script into a recorded audio file in Spanish Portuguese, and 4 other languages. It's very easy to use. And although it's not perfect, workers report they can easily understand it. Here's a clip with a Spanish voiceover prepared using this software.
La forma correcta de mover una rejilla a un espacio reducido es moviendo los dedos en el interior de la rejilla de envío y luego, para completar el almacenamiento de la rejilla, bloqueo las ruedas giratorias con cualquier tipo de madera o ladrillo para evitar que la rejilla se mueva.
The fourth and final video production step involves editing everything together. Using the editing software, you combine the recorded voiceover, in English or Spanish, with the assembled video scenes. Here are a few editing tips to increase your video's impact. Leave a brief pause between the different scenes of the video. This helps viewers realize that you're changing topics and gives some time for information to sink in. If you find that the narration is too slow or too fast, go back and re-record it. It's worth the extra effort. In some instances, such as hearing a piece of equipment start up, it may be helpful to include the background sound, but at a level that doesn't interfere with the voiceover. If you can, add on-screen titles throughout the video to introduce different scenes, as you've seen done in this video. So that's it. Creating your own short training videos is a great way to help maintain an accident-free workplace. And by following the suggestions in this video, it shouldn't be too difficult to produce your own short videos that help your employees in doing their jobs safely. Thanks for watching. WSPS wishes to acknowledge the support of Jeffrey's Greenhouses in the production of this video.